Roxanne, my name's Melissa. I'll be your nurse. How you doing?
I don't feel good at all. This is totally different than how
she's
I've been feeling.
She's not on
like
this.
I feel hot.
Okay, it might be because your water broke.
No. You don't understand. That's not it.
The abrupt change in vitals with desaturation and tachycardia prompt concern for an embolic event. Clinical support is called. When a code is called, roles are quickly assigned as the code team is called. Chest compressions start immediately.
On three, we're going to roll her to put on the back lead and put under the backboard.
Roll.
Okay, let's roll. Effort should be made to minimize intervals between chest compressions.
To the other side and put her left lateral.
Timing.
I need some more nurses in here for help. All right, you're going to be next for compressions. Rosemary, I need 1 milligram of epinephrine drawn up. Shannon, you're our scribe. Andy, you're our timekeeper.
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Assigning roles is important in a code situation. Chest compressions are performed at 30 to 2 with rescue breaths pending an advanced airway.
1 minute.
Hey, what's going on in here?
Hi, she suddenly lost consciousness and she has no pulse. She started.
Communication with new members to the code, such as anesthesia, is important. Chest compressions should rotate at least every 2 minutes to avoid fatigue.
Epinephrine drawn up.
Okay, you continue to run
the
airway
right now.
No, we shouldn't. She's too unstable right now.
2 minutes.
Okay.
All right.
Obstetric delivery is not considered in a code situation until time is approaching 4 minutes, and the patient should not be moved as this would compromise maternal resuscitation. During a code, heart rhythm should be evaluated every 2 minutes to consider shock administration.
Okay. Looks like she's bleeding a lot. Can we activate the massive transfusion protocol?
Yes.
A massive transfusion protocol is essential in the resuscitation of a rapidly hemorrhaging obstetric patient. One should be familiar with their own institutional protocol.
Okay.
Breath. 1, 2, 3,
Melissa, you'll be taking over after Art's
done.
With placement of an advanced airway, chest compressions thereafter are continuous, with 6 to 8 mechanical breaths per minute.
How many minutes has it been now?
4 minutes.
Okay, all right.
Cesarean delivery is mobilized when a non-perfusible rhythm persists after 4 minutes. Maternal resuscitative efforts should not be hindered in the process.
5 minutes!
Alright, we're starting the C-section.
Vertical midline incision.
Okay, I'll take over the
compressions during the section. Very good, Sarah.
With cesarean delivery during a code, chest compressions continue, the code continues, and a vertical incision facilitates rapid delivery.
Alright,
get this baby out.
Go ahead and drop another milligram of epirotary.
Thank you, you're right behind.
Okay. When was our last epinephrine?
Yep, right here.
Right? Keep going.
There we go. All right, baby out.
6 minutes.
There you go.
Pediatrics should be available for a potentially viable but compromised neonate.
All right,
for another quickly.
Okay, 1327 delivery. Right. Okay, we're going to go ahead with 6 minutes, and we're going to do a pulse check.
Another minute.
Stop and check the pulse. I'm sewing the uterus.
Let's check the rhythm.
Okay, great.
Rhythm,
okay,
yes.
Okay, the rhythm is beeping. That's a shockable rhythm, so we're going to charge.
Charge.
Yep, I think it's really coming. Sam, nobody's charged? Okay, Sam, one hand clear. No need shockers.
I'm clear, you're clear, we're all clear. Okay, just shocking. Resume CPR?
All right. 7 minutes.
All right, we're done with this.
Rosemary, let's be ready with our next round of
medicine. All right. Let's pack her belly and get her ready.
All right.
Following delivery, the incisions are rapidly closed or packed so as not to interfere with the ongoing code.
Okay, it's time for another pulse check. On the next switch, go ahead and we'll check for a pulse.
All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, step back, check for a pulse. I feel a pulse.
I got a pulse as well. Okay, so we got a pulse back.
Following successful resuscitation, steps are taken to optimize post-cardiac arrest care after the return of spontaneous circulation.
Let's run his blood pressure here. Blood pressure is still pretty low, so let's go ahead and start an epi infusion. We'll continue the massive transfusion protocol. Can you go ahead and hang another round of blood and FFP as well? I think we're going to send some labs off. Can you go ahead and draw some labs for me? And then we'll be heading to the ICU soon.
Sounds good.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. Management of the gravid patient in a code situation is similar to any other patient. Bedside cesarean delivery should be pursued during a code lasting 5 minutes if the gestational age is greater than 20 weeks. Efforts spent on delivery should not detract from other efforts in the ongoing code. Mobilization of adequate team and resources can be critical. Awareness of your institution's massive transfusion protocol will help facilitate timely management in an emergency.